This is the Tasty and Pusey cooking show. And we actually say, instead of Pusey and Tasty, it's Pasty. That is the name of our show.
I love them. They're so interesting. They're endlessly interesting. That one next to you, very, very interesting. This one, diabolically interesting. This one, a little hidden, but very, very interesting. Love this one to death, sweetest. This one. And the heavenly Danielle. No, I adore them.
This is real Velveeta.
No, it's not. That was a quick, that was a trick question.
You did not make cheese.
This is real.
Oh, well, congratulations.
I really don't think of her as crazy. One, because I have been able to now decode what she's saying, and so it makes perfect sense to me. I'm like, I know exactly what she's saying. I know how we got to Modesto from Modesty. I know what train she was on. Sometimes I catch it myself.
I think we both knew it was coming because right. I think a lot of the fans were like, we want Jackie and Diana hook up. We didn't know it was going to happen, but like since we were such besties on the show and we're mm-hmm. always together and we were like, it wouldn't be funny if this would happen. I think the fans would go crazy. Mm-hmm. And then we were preparing for it. We were just like, girl, you better brush your teeth. And you better eat a mint before this. And that was mostly me because I'm very like, you need to do this. And Jackie's like, you need to chill. I'm going to have coffee before, and that's the way it's going to be.
I'm not complaining because I will say that now that it's over, you know, the memory of it, and I think this is the most acting stuff, and also childbirth, is that it's, like, in my mind's eye, it just felt like we were, like, so, like, alive and almost like we went to battle together, you know? Because it was, I just remember, like, Taylor, and at some point she, like, the lighter, because it was, like, a makeshift lighter, and she just, like, got a giant burn on her hand. But because, you know, she was corned out, she kept just like, she would just stare at it periodically, like, is that really happening? And then Prepon and I would be like, I think that is really happening.
Yeah, you turned yourself badly.
The wrong way.
Oh, God. Yeah. Oh, God.
Yeah, we held it the perfect way.
You don't smoke enough
crack. They were pros.
So I think it's time to taste it. Samira, will you be our taste tester here? You gotta eat it with your hands because we're not prepared on the pasty show.
You do have things. Cute little ears.
I do.
Do you think that they wrote that about you when they saw your ears? They were like, we've got to mention how cute they are.
Oh, that's so, never thought of that. I was just like, who the hell is paying attention to my ears?
I get through this whole day gangbusters. I did not reveal a single spoiler. And then I was visiting my boyfriend, my tiny airport in Burbank. This story is so long. And then it's an empty airport, and I'm really patting myself on the back, like, good job, kid.
You made it through everything and didn't reveal anything.
Yeah. And then a lovely TSA agent said, I'm such a big fan of the show. Are you coming back this year? And I without looking, without blinking, I just said, yes, of course. It was such a weird moment.
She legally could detain you at that point.
So, of course, then I go full-scale panic. One thing leads to another, nothing happened. That's the end of the story. Everything's fine.
But we dismember a body, you know? and there's, like, blood, like, squirting up. Like, literally, I'm, like, doing the saw, and there's someone underneath, like, flicking blood up.
I was not cool like that in high school. I wish. I don't even think I had that many friends. But I didn't, I swear.
Stop lying.
I swear.
Stop lying.
If I had to take someone with me, oh, man, it might be, like, Leah Delaria, like a big
really?
Blue.
Yeah.
Yo, where my donuts?
Because I love her. Yeah. I adore her no end. I adore Taryn. She knows it. She's T-Money. She's my shouty.
That hurt to the core. That hurt
really?
To the core.
No.
That's okay.
My bad.
I'll take you too.
No. I wasn't going to say you, so you can say Leah.
Selenis. And if it's really hard, you could just say Selly.
Selly, can
all
I call
my,
you that?
Yeah, could call me Selly. All my closest people call me Selly.
Because that's not,
call me
Selly. It's not like a Spanish
it's
name.
It's not Maria. It's not, you know, Juanita.
Guadalupe.
It's not Guadalupe. Fernandez Martinez. No.
Or Maribel.
Exactly.
Or Jennifer. Yeah, it's not. So, but it's not a Spanish name anyway, right?
My father swears, my father's Cuban. He was like, yeah, I invented it. And then I looked it up. It's Greek.
Maybe something like, before I met you, the sun was like a yellow grape, but now it looks like fire in the sky. Why? Crikey! Crocodile Dundee 4!
coming from theater, like I was in my first year, you know, trying to come up with my backstory for my character. And like, I had this whole relationship of like, oh, this is my mom. This is the kind of thing we do with my mom. And then I realized in episode 12 of first season, oh, my mom been dead for 6 years.
Some of the newer characters that you guys will be introduced to this season, it was hard to see them outside of the prison garb. And I was literally, I was having this conversation. It was myself, Cindy Holland, and this other young lady named Kelly. And we were just talking. And I'm thinking she's asking, you know, just congratulating me on the show. She's a fan and all this kind of stuff. And I said, well, thank you so much for enjoying the show. And she was like, yeah, I can't wait to get back to the new season. And I was like, wait, who are you again? And I was literally talking to the character that plays Sankey on the show, and I didn't realize, because awesome. I mean, she has like straight blonde hair, and she has this like, on the show, she has like a lower pitched kind of New Yorkian voice, but now it's like, she kind of talks up here, and it's like, I'm Kelly, you know, you remember me? I'm like, you're Sankey! So that threw me off for a second.
Well, my wish and my want is that, and hope is that I would be this, you know, badass, really tough, you know, scary, don't mess with me kind of woman, but I feel like in the end I'd probably be like, I'll do whatever you say.
It's so weird to me when people tell me that I'm some sort of icon or role model, because let me tell you, Umberto, honestly, if I'm a role model for queers, we're in a fuck of a lot of trouble.
I would like Taylor Schilling to give us her best Alex Voss impression.
Okay, you can do that.
Just say something like,
"Hey, girl."
Something
hey.
Like,
"Girl."
Something like maybe like, "Hey,
girl."
Like,
a lot deeper.
Yeah. Hey, girl. Like hey. A husky, crispy hey. Voice. Bring it on, bring
Jump
it on.
Down a little bit.
For example, give me this line. "Hey, pipes. How'd you sleep last night?"
"Hey, pipes."
Never has your voice been so deep.
"Hey, pipes. How'd you sleep last night?" All right.
I'm just kidding.
I get very nervous as it starts to get closer.
Every time she gets nervous. Every time I'm like, you're going to be fine. It's going to be okay. Every time. So nervous. So you're the calm one.
Yes.
Well, only because she's made me that way. I want to be the nervous one, but she's just so damn nervous.
Adrian, you play Black Cindy.
Yeah.
Now
well, her new name is Tova. Let's go.
Okay, we're gonna go with Tova then.
Shalom, everyone.
Smell fantastic.
Really?
Yes, you smell fantastic. What are you
wearing?
You smell great.
I am shocked to hear that.
Really? You usually not smell good?
I mean, listen, I can't really smell myself, as I think is the case with most people.
Yeah.
And I think that's how things usually take a dark turn.
There's this hallway where a lot of the cast is, and everyone always brings their dogs to set, and they're running all over the place.
Oh,
and
I love that.
You know, we go in and get a hair touch-up. There's like three dogs in this one room.
And Laura likes to play chat roulette.
Okay, all right. So, she likes to get on the chat roulette. I mean,
talk to people.
Sometimes you meet really cool people. One time I was talking to this group of military guys who were like, you know, overseas, and it was awesome because they were like, we miss home so much, and we were all chatting, and it was fun.
And of course, if you have this face to see,
where you
they weren't expecting.
Yeah, I think I would pitch.
Yeah.
I think Piper would pitch.
With your hair like half over.
Correct. I would pitch with like that. I would pitch with this look.
Yeah.
You would never know what
that
I was thinking.
Really cool
so
turn,
intimidating.
Just, you can only see one eye.
Yeah.
That's how much you don't know what's coming.
They're gonna put crazy eyes out in right field where the ball never
you're
goes.
Right. What is your New Year's resolution?
Uh-oh, right. Didn't that already pass? I feel like if I had one,
yeah.
It's gone.
Are you still working on it though? It's still January. Yeah.
Do you have one?
I mean, no.
Oh, you know, I was going to have one, but then Taryn didn't, and I felt like I was off the hook, so I'm going to go with no.
But we all did chat roulette one day. There were like six of us around the dressing room table.
And we were just, I
think it was in your dressing room, and there were like six of us around
Laura
the computer.
Laura used her anonymous email account, and we were like trolling the internet, trying to find some people, and then all of a sudden this guy like pops up on the screen, and we were so scared we just jumped back. We were like, whoa, there's somebody asking.
Yeah. I would say there's not a lady in red is dancing with me cheek to cheek. That's a good prison song, right? Because it's like,
oh my god, I didn't know if you could sing. Okay,
I'm like
just
always
such
singing
a voice, right?
And playing. I'm like, there's a lot of stuff I'm into. Yeah.
Okay guys, thank you
voice
so much
writing.
Thank you, Daphne.
I have to go
aerobic.
Thank you so much for your time.
You.